So today we are going to discuss about forms of energy. We are going to discuss about forms of energy. And in forms of energy, there are many forms in our textbook. But as I have said yesterday, for your convenience, we will discuss only small portions every day. And my request is that you have to study the portion what we are discussing today. You have to study very well. Okay, so moving to the next class or the second part of our chapter, energy. Today we are going to discuss about forms of energy. Forms of energy. So you know, energy can exist in many forms. Yesterday itself we have seen that the sun is the ultimate source of energy, and from the sun we are getting actually heat energy, we are getting then light energy, we are getting, and using light energy the plants are preparing food. Then after that, how much they have to need for your life, they will use that one, and rest of the energy they will be stored. Then after that, what we will do? The energy stored can be used by vegetarians, and that animal will be using the energy for their life, and the remaining energy will be stored on your body, on their body, and after that part, there will be food chain is continuing. So each of these energies can be transferred from one form to another form. Okay, all the energy, whether if it is heat energy sometimes can be changed into light energy, or the light energy can be changed into any other forms of energy. So that's why we are going to discuss about forms of energy today. And today we are going to discuss about mainly one term or mainly one form of energy, first form of energy, that is mechanical energy. That is mechanical energy. So as you know already, mechanical energy, or yesterday we have seen, energy is the capacity of body to do work. Energy is the capacity of the body to do work. But here I am telling that we are going to discuss like this. In order to, suppose in your textbook there is can you just look at the page number 35, there is one figure 3.1 is shown. Figure 3.1 is shown. So there you can see a person is standing somewhere, and just below his or on the ground there is a stone, and the work he is going to do is, he is going to take the stone from the ground, and he is going to just raise that one at a particular position, at a height. Okay, so here two things are there. One is object. Our object is the stone which is placed on the floor. And next action is, I am going to apply some amount of force. Yesterday we have seen what was joule. When we are telling joule, when 1 newton force is applied, and if the object is moving in the same direction of force applied, then we can say that we have done some amount of work. So here I am going to do work. My work is, I want to raise the stone from the ground to at a particular height. Okay, so in order to do that, I am going to apply some amount of force on the stone. So maybe stone will be at the ground. I am going to apply some amount of force. In which direction? I am raising it up. So I can say that this is the direction of force I have applied. I am going to raise the stone upside. So I have applied some amount of force, and then what will happen? The stone will be raised up. So if I am applying some force on an object, if the object is moving in the same direction in which I have applied the force, then I can say that I have done some amount of work. This much is clear now? What is work? How we can say that some amount of work is done? If I am applying some force on an object, in a particular direction, so that the object is moving from that particular position to another particular position in the same direction of applied force, then I can say that some amount of work I have done. Clear? Now, here in this case, what I have done, stone was on the floor, and from the ground, the higher place, the higher applying the force on the outside direction, so that the stone is raised to at a particular height. So I can say that some amount of work is done. Some amount of work is done. Okay, this is already we have discussed in class 6. So this is the definition of work. What is the definition of work? When we are applying some amount of force on a body, if the body is moving in the same direction of applied force, then we can say that we have done some amount of work. Okay, now moving to the definition of mechanical energy. What is mechanical energy? The energy possessed by a body, due to the work done on it is, known as mechanical energy. What is mechanical energy? Energy possessed by an object due to the work done on it is called mechanical energy. So here in this case, what will be the mechanical energy? This is the ground level. I am applying some amount of force in the upward direction so that the stone is raising up to a height. So from here to this side, the stone is raised so that I can say that I have done some amount of work. So how much work is done by me on this object will be stored in the form of mechanical energy. How much work done on this body by me will be stored in the form of mechanical energy, or we can say that the mechanical energy will be equal to the work done, the total work done on this particular object. Now, yesterday we have seen that in order to do work, we need energy. Is it not? So, if my body is having some amount of energy, then only I can supply the force on this object. Okay, so this is called a mechanical energy. So once again I will explain. Mechanical energy is the total work done on a particular body. In the example given in the textbook, we are doing some amount of work in order to raise the stone from the ground level to the particular height. So in order to bring that stone from the ground to the at a height, I have applied some amount of force and the object is moved in the same direction of force, so that it is clear that I have done some amount of work. And the mechanical energy stored on the stone will be equal to the work done by me on that particular body. Okay, now, you know, work done on the body when it is displaced, that means work will be done only when it is displaced. Suppose, instead of this a small stone, I am giving sometimes a 100 kilogram stone on the floor. Okay, and I am going to apply some amount of, a huge amount of force on the stone. Will the stone will be raised up? The stone will not raise up. That means there is no displacement. If there is no displacement, even if I have applied some amount of force, then there is no work is done. Then I can say that if the body is not moving, then the mechanical energy will be equal to zero. That means work done is zero. If the work done is zero, work is zero, then say mechanical energy is equal to zero. If the work is done to a maximum, then that the energy will be equal to how much work I have done on this particular stone. Okay, is it clear for you? If it is clear, you can just raise your hand. In the video, I can see you. Then, after that, we are going to discuss about, we are going to divide this mechanical energy into two categories. First one, we are going to divide this energy into kinetic energy. We are going to divide the mechanical energy into kinetic energy. Okay, depending upon the nature, how the object is, we are going to divide this one into kinetic energy and second one is potential energy. This can be also represented by kinetic energy as capital K E and potential energy will be equal to gap letter PE. So I hope you understood what is mechanical energy. Now we are going to divide the mechanical energy into two categories. First one is kinetic energy represented by capital KE, and second one is potential energy represented by capital PE. Okay, these two forms of energy, that means they are coming under mechanical energy. This is one is kinetic energy and another one is potential energy. These are having a relation, that means this can be kinetic energy can be changed into potential energy. The same way the potential energy can be changed into kinetic energy that we are going to discuss. Now, how we have divided kinetic energy and potential energy? Depending upon which criteria we have divided these two classes. Kinetic energy means energy possessed by a body when it is under motion. Motion and thrust already you know. The main or the characteristic of the kinetic energy possessed by a body, the body will be under motion. The body will be under motion. Then another one state is there. What is the other state? Rest. If the body is at rest or weaker position, there will be a particular position will be there. Rest of position. Energy possessed by those type of bodies, we can say that potential energy. So it is clear. The mechanical energy we have divided into two classes: kinetic energy and potential energy. How we have divided this one? Kinetic energy will be energy possessed by a body when it is under motion, and potential energy will be the energy of a body is the energy possessed by its own virtue of position, or it is not moving, it is at rest, it is having a particular position. Now we are going to discuss about kinetic energy. What is kinetic energy? What is kinetic energy? Kinetic energy of a body is the energy possessed by it due to its state of motion or movement. Due to its state of motion or movement. Due to its state of motion or movement. This is called kinetic energy. This is called kinetic energy. All moving things in the world or nature, when we are considering about the objects which is in the nature, all the moving one will possess kinetic energy. For example, when I am walking, I am having kinetic energy. When you are riding a cycle, you are having kinetic energy. Then a moving bus, when you are sitting on a vehicle which is running, you possess, or that vehicle possesses kinetic energy. Then flowing water, that means when the water is flowing, it is having kinetic energy. Whatever objects in the world which is having motion or which is having a movement will be having kinetic energy. Will be having kinetic energy. Even the moving wind also will have the kinetic energy. The moving wind also will be having kinetic energy. Now, the kinetic energy possessed by a body is directly proportional to their mass and velocity. The kinetic energy is directly proportional to the mass and the velocity. Okay, so there is a mathematical expression for this one. Kinetic energy will be equal to A will be equal to, or directly proportional to, half into mass of the body into velocity square. Velocity we have studied in chapter 2. What is velocity? Mass we have studied in class 6. So both we have learned. So the relationship between kinetic energy is directly proportional to mass of the body and the velocity, the square of the velocity. Or we can say, or we can rewrite this one, half mv square, where m is mass of the body and v is the velocity of the body. V is the velocity of the body. This is the mathematical expression for kinetic energy. This is the mathematical expression for kinetic energy. This is very important in the class 7 we need, 8, 9, 10, and when you are going in 11, 12, if you opt to 6 also, these are the basic equations what we are applying. So, kinetic energy is the energy possessed by a body when it is under motion or a movement, and kinetic energy is directly proportional to mass of the body and the velocity, square of the velocity. Then we can say that mathematical expression K is equal to half mv square, where m is mass of the body and v is the velocity. V is the velocity. Okay, this much is clear for you. Next one, we are going to discuss about potential energy. We are going to discuss about potential energy. What is potential energy? Potential energy of a body is the energy possessed by virtue of its position. By virtue of its position, or we can say that the body is not moving, the body is at rest. If the body is at rest, then only it is having a particular, then only it will be having a particular position. If I am standing here without moving, you can say that I am having a particular position. So, but if I am just walking here, my position is changing. So, if I need a particular position, my body should be at rest. So, potential energy is the energy possessed by the body by virtue of its position. Potential energy of two types again. Gravitational potential energy and elastic potential energy. Okay, this V is of two types. Gravitational and elastic potential energy. Okay, again this potential energy we are divided into two. One is gravitational potential energy and second one is elastic potential energy. Now, before that, the mathematical expression, even though it is not given in the textbook, the mathematical expression for potential energy is, potential energy is directly proportional to mass of the body, acceleration due to gravity, that means gravitational constant, and height of the body, that means up to which height I have a key. So P is equal to mgh, where m is the mass of the body, g is the gravitational constant that we will discuss, then h is the height of the body. So if the mass is increasing, the potential energy will be increasing. If the gravity is a constant quantity, and if the height is increasing, then also the potential energy will be increasing. That means if I am placing one bucket of water in the first floor of one stool, and if I place the same size of bucket of water on the third floor of the stool, the first floor will be having less energy compared to the third floor, because third floor is having more height. It is directly proportional. Okay, now we are going to discuss about gravitational potential energy. An object is said to have gravitational potential energy due to its raised position. That's what we are discussing. Mainly we are discussing always about gravitational potential. Gravitational potential energy is said to have, if the body is said to have a gravitational potential energy, then the object should be raised up. This chalk is having a gravitational potential energy because I have raised this one at this height or this height. This is not at the ground level. It is having a particular height and it is having a particular mass. So we can say that the gravitational potential energy is due to the raised position of this body. And in the page number 35, we have discussed about the first activity figure 3.1. The work is done by lifting a stone. Initially the stone was at ground level. We have placed that one at a height. We have raised that one at a height. This is because work has to be done to raise the body to certain height against the force of gravity. Thus, when a brick is raised to a height, it gains gravitational potential energy. Or we can say that when we have placed something on a ground floor, that means ground level, gravitational energy will be always towards the air, that means towards down. If we want to lift it one into another, if we we want to raise this one at a particular height, at a particular position, I have to apply some amount of force which is opposite or against the gravitational force. So this is the force applied by me in order to raise the stone or that brick at a height. So I am raising this one at a height. So the brick is having a particular mass. There will be gravitational constant will be there, and PE will be is equal to mgh. Like this we will derive. Okay, so that's why we are telling, in order to raise this one from ground level to a particular height, we have to do some amount of work. And how much work we have done in order to raise this object from this ground level to at a particular height will be equal to the potential energy stored on that particular object. Will be equal to that potential energy stored on that particular object. For example, another one example. In your school, in your home, all are having water tank, right? Water tank will be there, and the electric motor also will be there. Okay, water tank will be there, and electric motor also will be there. When we are switching on the electric motor, what will happen? From the well, the water will be raised at a particular position on a tank. So here, work is done by the motor, electric motor. Electric motor is having a particular force, and it is applying a force against gravity and raising the water through the pipe in a tank. So it is raised on the tank. So in order to raise from the well to the tank, the motor has done some amount of work. How much amount of work the motor has done, that much energy will be stored on the tank. Water is not flowing in the tank, it will be stored. It is having a particular position, so it is having a potential energy. This is called gravitational potential energy. Again, mangoes. A mango on a tree or water stored in a reservoir dam. Okay, have potential energy owing their height. Mango is a particular height fixed from the ground level. So it is having potential energy. And comparing with kinetic energy and potential energy, you just imagine when the, you know, already dams are created between the mountains. In mountains, we will create dams. We know from the river, water is flowing. When the water is flowing, it is having kinetic energy. Already, we know if the water is having some moment, it will be having kinetic energy. Then, when it is stored in the dam or reservoir, it is not moving. So, at that time, this will be having potential energy. At that time, this will be having potential energy. So that's why the first I have said this, we can interchange potential energy into kinetic energy and kinetic energy into potential energy. As you know, when we are fetching the water from the well, it is having kinetic energy until it is reaching on the top of that means tank. When it is reaching the tank, this kinetic energy will be converted into potential energy. Then it is having potential energy. And when you are opening the tap, that potential energy, the water will start flowing, that means so much. At that time, potential energy will be converted into kinetic energy. So that's why in the first itself, I have said, or in the given that, the kinetic energy can be transferred into potential energy, and the potential energy can be again transferred into kinetic energy. Then, the last topic is that elastic potential energy. Elastic potential energy. What is elastic potential energy? Elastic potential energy of a body is the energy that gets stored in when the body is stretched or compressed. For example, you are familiar with the rubber band, right? You are familiar with the rubber band. We are able to stretch the rubber band back. That means I am applying some amount of force in backward direction and the rubber band itself is stretching back. So I can say that I have done some amount of work. So it is clear. How much amount of work I have done in order to stretch the rubber band back, that much energy is stored in the form of potential energy. And we are able to, sometimes people, the students know, they will keep some, a small bit of paper, then we will release. The stored potential energy will be converted into kinetic energy and paper will be moving at a particular distance. This is what happens when a stretched catapult possesses elastic potential energy. You just look at page number 36, figure 3.5. Page number 36, figure 3.5, you can see a stretched catapult possesses elastic energy. there is also conversion of this potential energy and kinetic energy. We are keeping that stone or that elastic, that rubber, and we are then stretching it back, that catapult, and then what will happen, I am doing some amount of work, then the potential energy is stored. As soon as we have released this one, suddenly what will happen, this will be moving, stretching forward, that means the potential energy suddenly will be changing into kinetic energy, and that stone will be moving very fast to a long distance. So this is called elastic potential energy. Elastic potential energy. And one more example is there. When we are discussing about toys, toy cars are familiar with to you. In the childhood, you might have learned about, you might have used toy cars. Even sometimes some people are using now also. So there will be one key is there. One key is there where you can just rotate that one in order to make tight. So inside that one spring will be there, spring like material will be there. So when you are rotating, you are doing some amount of work. Once it is stretched fully, then after that you cannot turn it back. If you release, what will happen? The toy car will start moving. So when we are doing some amount of work in order to stretch that one, that amount of work will be stored in the form of potential energy. And when we are releasing the key, what will happen? This potential energy will be converted into kinetic energy and the toy car will start moving forward. So the potential energy will be converted into kinetic energy. So what is gravitational potential energy? Gravitational potential energy of the body, energy gets stored in when the body is stretched or compressed. How it is compression? Spring is familiar with you, spring. Spring will be having a huge, sometimes very lengthy will be there. If you are applying some amount of force, this can be compressed into very small, this much. It will become this much. Applying force in this direction, I can bring this one into up to here. So I have done some amount of work. That work will be stored in the form of potential energy. When we are placing that one, suddenly it will go back to the old position. So it is kinetic energy. So this is elastic potential energy. Is it clear for you? If it is clear, you can just raise your hand. We have discussed about two types of potential energy. One is gravitational potential energy, and the second one was elastic potential energy. What is gravitational potential energy? Gravitational potential energy is the energy possessed by a body when it is placed at a height, whereas elastic potential energy is the energy possessed by a body by stretching or compressing. The main idea that you have to keep it in mind, that all here we are doing some amount of work. How much work we have done will be stored in the form of energy. That is called the mechanical energy, and depending upon the nature, we have seen mechanical energy as kinetic energy and the potential energy, and we have seen the mathematical expression. Then again, potential energy we have divided into gravitational potential energy and elastic potential energy. Okay, so this is about our today's portion, and you can, as I have said yesterday, you may just go to the study questions. Don't wait for the PDF handout. You may go to the study questions, and in the rough book, you try to do that answers. Okay,